Hey everyone, it's present day for us. Just here to let you know that this video is made in 2018. It does not reflect how I'm going to make the tutorial series I've mentioned as of recently. Doomskii, a friend of mine, found this video, so I figured I'd re-upload it. All of the information is still relevant, but is not canon to how I'm making future videos. More information in the pinned comment. If a well-organized Guitar Hero expert could simply make a tutorial series covering more advanced alt-tapping or just an informative instructional on how to hit specific patterns that we see over and over again in most of these customs, then I think a lot of people would be further encouraged to at least learn. Guitar Hero needs that boost, I feel. Well, look no further than Frosted Guitar Hero. Yes, yes, the man that does the things is finally hopping off of his stout behind to make a tutorial series, which I've talked about in plenty of other streams in the past. With the help of my editor Moody, as well as suggestions from my Discord, we're going to try to break down various aspects of the Guitar Hero / Clone Hero playstyle to make patterns and overall methods more understandable for the standard player. So, without further ado, let's hop directly into part 1, everything to do with strumming. One of the first things that I originally had issues with when learning how to play Guitar Hero again back in 2013 was strumming. Back then, the main thing that halted my progress was the attempt to alt-strum every note on screen, and that's generally a mistake. You'll want to let go of the strum bar sometimes to make sure you're doing the correct amount of strums. If you're familiar with how steps in music work, with 16th notes, if the strumming sequence starts and ends on a beat line, you'll start and end that strumming sequence with a down strum. A good example of this is in Revolution Death Squad. Throughout the verses of this song, you'll be required to let go of the strum bar and press down strum quite a few times. For the most part, when the notes are slow enough, it's better to just down strum unless you're comfortable with alt strumming. You'll get more control over your strumming that way. Next thing to note is strumming sequences that have hammer-on notes between the strums themselves. These are normally split up into portions with either one or three strums, and while you can strum them the same way as usual, the key to hitting these sections is to fret the notes on screen slightly before you actually strum. That way the game has enough time to register the hammer-ons before accepting a strum input. This type of methodology is quite common in custom songs since it's a rather fun pattern to play, but it can also be seen in specific Dragon Force songs like Through the Fire and Flames, Valley of the Damned, Soldiers of the Wasteland, Cry for Eternity, and more. If you pay close attention to the strumming motions here, you'll see that I'm very heavily relying on downstrumming to maintain consistency. While this is a minor detail, it's quite important for gaining strumming consistency. In some sections, the strumming parts get too quick to be able to reset strum, as shown before. Once you get used to letting go of the strum bar and counting the proper amount of notes, you'll be able to do less strum resets for burst strumming. A good example of this is in Solus 4, the section Victory Verse, has strumming that, while possible, should not be reset strummed for the purpose of saving stamina. If you want to get better at this style of strumming, count your inputs in sets of 3. A down-up-down strum sequence is 3, and so is an up-down-up sequence. Switching between these two is a good method of hitting bursts of 3 strums that are quite close to each other, and due to the lenience of Clone Hero's input reception engine, you don't have to time this super well when the strumming is fast. Obviously, this isn't very easy to learn just by watching, so it would be best if you tried it out on your own. A good quote-unquote beginner section for this might be Raining Blood Chug Chugs or Barracuda. This next tip is fairly intuitive since it involves a skill which is very easy to improve, and that's strumming stamina. Players like Sendit, Yuri, Cully, Abishan, Lemon, as well as many others have taken strumming stamina to insane heights, and they've all done it the same way. Playing songs that force them to strum until their arm cannot strum anymore, and then resting for a bit and doing it all again. While there are a few tricks you can use to boost your stamina for a moment, such as rotating your bicep when you start to feel your arm give out, strumming more lightly than you would usually, switching between wrist and shoulder strumming, but it mostly comes down to playing a song that challenges your strength and stamina. An excellent song that meets this criteria is The Holy Mountain by Slice the Cake. The ending of the song, marked as chorus in practice mode, has 3,000 straight notes of 11 to 12 notes per second strumming. Since the speed isn't too bad and can likely be achieved by any player regardless of skill level, attempting to play this section until you're able to FC it is a good first step. Then once you can do that consistently, bump the speed up to 110. Once you can do that, try 115, then 120, and on and on. This might sound like a tiring and cumbersome process, and while that's true to an extent, you'll see improvement in this aspect of your skill extremely quickly, usually within the first day of trying. Another thing to note, improving your strumming stamina like this doesn't only help with strumming, it eventually equates to raising your overall speed as a player, which is extremely handy to have if you ask me. While this is a difficult thing to explain, it's worth mentioning considering it's the basis for tapping in general. Elbow strumming is quite difficult to get used to since there's separate inputs that you need to use in order to utilize the technique properly. The first one is rather simple, and it can be shown with a Through the Fire and Flames intro. A falling edge elbow strum is an elbow strum that emphasizes on a higher note and then goes downwards. In this example, it's the red, then falls to green. The technique involves holding down the red, then using your elbow to hit the strum bar, and then releasing the red to continue the sequence. For those of you with smaller arms, or those of you who are young, this is still possible, but it will be much harder to do considering the stretching needed. That's why I recommend using an Explorer guitar, since the notes and the strum bar are closer together than most models. This is another example of something that needs to be practiced physically rather than listening to the tutorial, so I recommend trying it out in-game. The next form of elbow strumming is called rising edge elbow strumming, meaning you elbow strum on an anchor note and perform a tapping sequence afterwards. The reason this is so much harder is you're displacing your fingers away from their normal position, so performing the tapping sequence after hitting the elbow strum is harder than usual. This can be expressed using WTF sweeps from Dark Caves of Ulno. Now obviously, this is a very confusing pattern and I'm not going to teach you how to do tapping patterns yet, but stay tuned for a future part in the series if you do want to see how to do those things. What needs to be focused on here is how I'll elbow strum before tapping. Getting this down is much harder than with falling edge, but it's achievable if you put the proper practice in. Now again, this is something that you'll have to practice on your own time and not just by watching the video, though this is a good resource if you need to figure out how to do it in the first place. Now, before I jump into the realm of rake strumming, it's important to understand how your specific guitar works. Every guitar is different, so certain methods may change depending on how your strum switches react to certain inputs. Try this. Go to the menu in Clone Hero and slide your finger past the strum bar like so. If it only overstrums in one direction like mine, one finger rake strumming is a useful tool to help you hit triplet strumming sequences, like those shown in many strumming intensive charts such as Hyperforms. If it overstrums in both directions consistently, sections like I'm Sorry from Amalgamation, the hollow outro, and Epidox Crazy Strumming, along with many other four-note-based strumming sections, become much easier with one-finger raking. This is down to the way your guitar functions, and that's ultimately down to RNG, but the technique is simple nonetheless. By sliding your finger over the strum bar and allowing the strum bar itself to bounce backwards, you're essentially achieving more strum inputs than you're actually performing. This makes physical interaction with your guitar on higher notes per second strumming sequences a lot easier than just standard strumming them. Now, if your guitar doesn't overstrum either way, one finger raking will never be useful for any purpose, so ignore this portion of the video. TobyGH3 has a good tutorial on triple raking with a non-overstrumming guitar, and I recommend checking that out if you're in that situation. For those of you with an overstrumming guitar, Toby's method can be utilized for higher notes per second sections. If you're in the mood for passing challenges or want an easier time hitting sections like strumming verse from Solus 3, then this is a good technique to learn. By taking one finger raking and adding your thumb to the sequence, you're able to achieve an extra input for faster sequences of strumming. It's important that you're using your fingertips or your fingernails for this style of strumming. Using your knuckles will most definitely lead to tearing of the skin, and nobody wants that. You can take one finger raking and multiply it by using two fingers on the strum bar as well. The trick to two finger raking is to allow enough space between your fingers to account for the extra inputs. If you take two finger raking and apply your thumb as well by using the finger position shown on screen, you'll achieve the fastest form of raking that most guitars will allow. While you could simply add a ring finger for quad raking, you're essentially canceling out extra inputs by not allowing enough space between your fingers. So unless you're the great Kali, do not try quad rake strumming. Leaf Green, as well as others, have used the triple finger raking technique to hit crazy things such as 149 note streak on Ubersong strumming, 140 notes per second with chord strums, as well as many other crazy passes back in the Guitar Hero 3 days. The notes per second you can achieve is limited to how your strum switches react to overstrumming, but if you have an overstrumming guitar, go ham, just see how high you can get your notes per second. At this point, you're less relying on accuracy and more relying on raw speed, so don't expect to pull any FCs with these raking techniques, unless your guitar is extremely, extremely consistent. One final thing to note before I end off this part of the series, and this is less of a direct tutorial and more of an explanation of the two styles of strumming that I utilize to hit sections in the realm of 20 to 25 notes per second. The first method utilizes the wrist and finger combination that allows drummers to blast beat. In other words, by forcing your hand to quickly pulse and warble your middle fingers with the proper hand shape, you'll be able to strum using only your wrist for quick bursts of strumming. Stamina in this style of quote-unquote pulse strumming isn't the same as standard strumming, as it doesn't hurt the same way, but it's hard to maintain and it's only useful for 3 to 5 seconds without continuous practice. This is the technique that I used originally to FC I'm the One, as well as something I incorporate for various strumming sequences that fall between 20 and 23 notes per second. The second, and faster method, is to utilize the shaking that's produced when you flex your bicep and shoulders as hard as possible. what's achieved is a horizontal vibration. If you hold your hand at a 45 to 55 degree angle downwards on the guitar and grip the strum bar, the horizontal vibration will allow for strumming at 24 to 25 notes per second. And unlike pole strumming, this vibrate strumming technique is much more sustainable, but does hurt after a while. It's what I used in my The Violation 125% speedrun on my channel a while back to hit the choruses, and it's also what I used for the strumming and purification. Overall, this technique is the best for consistently fast strumming, but without raking. And that covers just about everything that has to do with strumming in this game. The next part in this series will focus on describing how to hit each style of basic alt-tapping patterns, from trills to trips to zigs to quads to quints. If I miss anything or you'd like extra clarification on a certain part of the video, feel free to leave a comment as I'll be reading all of them. Thanks everyone for watching, and I'll see you later. Somebody once told me the world's gonna rule me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead.